vlog. Nearly 9 o'clock. I've just got Blue here. I'm turning him out in the field, and then I'll go back and get Diddy because they cannot be trusted to go together. I've also put his leader around his nose because he's been really stupid to turn out recently. We've also got the farrier coming. So yeah, busy day. Okay, so I've now got Diddy. She's got her lightweight turnout rug on, primary equine one. And Blue is actually standing by the gate. Turning her out. Do you think she's absolutely starving? So she always snacks going out to the field, don't you? And Blue is there waiting for us. So that is both the ponies turned out in their field. So I'm now going back to the barn to go muck out and get all that stables ready and everything. Basically, the other horse who lives here is also having the farrier. So she's in like this really nice little paddock with tons of grass. And because Blue's a little bit underweight, he's going to go into that paddock once she comes in for the farrier. Diddy's going to stay on her own. Then Blue's going to have the farrier, and Diddy's going to come in, and then Blue's going to go out. And yeah, basically it's all just going to be a bit manic, swapping the horses around. But we're just trying to make sure they get as much time out as possible. So yeah, he's the most adorable yard dog. Hello. Hi. Good boy. Yeah, come on then. I don't worry about nothing. I am wearing a nada. I'm sitting pretty impatient, but I know you gotta put in them hours. I'ma make it harder. I'm sending pick after picture. I'ma get you fired. I know you're always on the night shift, but I can't stand these nights alone. And I don't need no explanation, 'cause baby, you're the boss at home. You don't gotta go to work, 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 but you gotta put in work. Okay, so I've mucked Blue's stable out, put new straw in and all that, and I've mucked Diddy's out, but I've banked it up because she's a lot wetter, so just like the floor to dry a bit. Now in the hay barn, this is their haylage. They both get a mixture of hay and haylage because they're both, Diddy's alright, but Blue's quite fussy. I'm just filling the wheelbarrow with haylage. I'm gonna split it between the two of them and then make the hay net. So I've swept the yard. I'm going to wash out their feed and water buckets, give them some water for this morning when they come back in, and then they feed. Let's put it in motion. I'ma give you a promotion. I'll make it. So now I'm making feeds. They both get chaff. Diddy just gets like really small amount, and Blue gets a full scoop of chaff, so sort of like that. And Blue also gets a full scoop of sugar beet. Right, because I'm not getting full scoops, I'll come back for it. Bit more for him. And if we have carrots, they both will have like half a carrot. Or he gets about half the yellow scoop of mix just to add to her chaff. Blue doesn't get any of this because it sends him a bit hyper. That is their feed.
Diddy also has some vitamins at the moment, just until she runs out of the packet, and then I just mix them up. So I'm now in Diddy's stable. I'm just going to put shavings down because they're both quite wet and there's no rubber mats, so we put shavings where they're wettest, and then I'll put her straw in, and then I brought a pile of clean straw earlier, so I will sort that out. Because she likes to eat her straw, we put the clean straw at the bottom and the dirty straw on top, and then spray it with like this vinegar solution thing to try and stop her eating it. Doesn't work that much. She still manages to eat her straw, but just trying to encourage her not to. That is both of their stables done. Waters, feeds, basically everything done. And because I'm staying here all day, I brought myself some food, so I'm going to go eat my food in the field with the ponies, and then I'll come back and clean the field now. It's actually so nice today. It's actually really warm, so I've just got my coat so I can sit on it. But I've got about an hour to an hour and a half till we have to start changing the horses over. So I'm just gonna eat my breakfast and just chill out in the field, really. I'm just gonna eat my lunch, breakfast, and just chill out in the field. I've got about an hour to an hour and a half till I actually have to start changing them over. It's also got really warm and really nice, so I'm gonna take Diddy's rug off. So yeah, oh, Bluey. Hey. He's like all over me, go away. Diddy's just eating. You're pretty go away, that's my foot. No, that's my lunch. That's my food. Oi! He just undid my shoelace. Go away! Go on! Go on! So, the idea of having a nice kind of quiet breakfast went completely out the window. As soon as I opened anything, they were both bombarding me, wanting whatever I had. So my sandwich, my drink, and I couldn't get them away from me. So I ended up standing up whilst eating and drinking, which they still didn't want to leave me. Diddy just wanted my 7-Up, and Blue just wanted either the foil or my food. He's now quite happy there, but he is edging closer and closer because I've now opened my crisps. Diddy is actually right behind the camera, so she's staying away from me. So I've now managed to actually sit down and eat some food, which is great. I'm just going on my phone and stuff and just enjoying watching them. Blue's very happy there. And I'm just going to take a little video of Diddy as well.
Diddy is in heaven. I took her rug off, obviously. If you haven't been groomed, because I just turned them out this morning, so just avoid that stain. Louis, what are you looking at?
And he's edging closer. He'll be on top of me in a minute again. And this is why I love Diddy. She's over there. I bet if Blue comes up to me, she'll come back. She hates being left out. And she gets very jealous. Hello. I turned my back for what was 5 seconds. Right, how could you not resist that face though? I wanted my food. Tough luck. You want to try, Chris? You got offended. I have never seen Diddy roll. Oh, bait! Oh, gosh, she's so muddy. Diddy! Bless her. This side seems to be alright. It's quite clean. What are you eating? We don't need nobody. I just need your body. Nothing but sheets in between us. Ain't no getting off early. I know you're always on the night shift, but I can't stand these nights alone. And I don't need no explanation, 'cause baby, did he look filthy after her roll? I definitely meant it. Oh god. Did I have fun grooming and bathing you, huh? See you in a bit. So it's about 11 o'clock now, so I'm gonna go back to the barn, start cleaning my tack, and then just wait for the farrier. And once he's here, then I'll take Blue out and move him to the other paddock. And yeah, let's go. Ooh, yeah. Girl, gotta work for me. Can you make a clap? No hands for me. Take it to the ground, pick it up for me. Look back at it all, I'm for me. Put in work like my time sheet. She ride it like a 63. I'ma buy a new Celine. So the farrier has just arrived. I'm now walking to the field to go get Blue because we are swapping Blue and Rosie. Well, no, we're putting Blue into Rosie's field while she gets her shoes. So he gets some extra grass. Diddy will be staying out on her own. So hopefully she'll be all right. And yeah, then I will come poo pick the field and keep an eye on Diddy. And yeah, should be good. Hopefully they're all well behaved and I can actually catch them. Blue and Diddy's by the gate, whinnying, wanting to come. Bless her. Come, Bluey. Oh, she's walking away now, so that's good. So he's now in this paddock. I think he's a bit confused, but Bluey. Actually see Diddy via that gap in the hedge, so he keeps smiling. And neighing for that matter. Yeah. Showing everyone his teeth. It's now Blue's turn for the farrier. He's having an absolute meltdown in the barn. So I've just come to get Diddy, who apparently has been galloping around all this time. So yeah, fun times just kind of run into the field because ponies have some separation anxiety today, which normally they don't. Have you been galloping? You're gonna be hot. So we've got Diddy and she is boiling. She is sweating so much. So obviously someone has been galloping about. You silly girl. Well, man, that was interesting to say the least. I actually can't believe how hot Diddy was. She's churned the field up quite a bit. So she's obviously been galloping around quite a lot. Although when I did check on her, she was stood by the gate, so she's obviously only just started galloping about. But oh god. They've never been difficult to part, but hey-ho. Blue's now having his feet done. He lost a shoe last week, so he's only having 3 new shoes. And I'm in the field
with the wheelbarrow, and I'm just going to start poo picking because we haven't done that for a while here. So yeah, the
wheelbarrow is full. Now we're going to go back to the barn, empty the wheelbarrow, and yeah, I need to hold Diddy for the farrier, so I will make my way back.
So that is both ponies done. I've just turned Diddy back out. That is Blue screaming and Diddy screaming. I'm going to go get Blue and turn him back out as well. It's actually quite early. The farrier was done really quick, so I'm going to let them go out for a bit longer. If the sun comes back out, I'm going to bath Diddy, but how it is at the moment, a bit too chilly for a bath. And then I will take her for a hack a bit later.
Someone is extremely excited to get out to Diddy, and Diddy is standing by the gate. Also quite happy to have company. Huh, ponies? You guys were left alone for like 5 seconds.
So I've just done some more poo picking. Got a full wheelbarrow behind me, and the ponies are quite happy. Diddy is there. Yep, there. And then Blue somewhere that way. They have actually settled now. Blue was very unsettled. He was calling to Rosie quite a lot a minute ago, but he seems to have settled now. There actually seems to be quite a few midges around, so I think tomorrow if it's like this they might need their flying rugs. So yeah. It is still quite warm, kind of on the fence whether or not to bath Diddy or not, but we might give it a go. So yeah.
So I've just emptied my wheelbarrow and grabbed some stuff, so I'm gonna go sit in the field with them again. But someone is by the gate neighing again, because he wants Rosie. Diddy's not good enough and he's very pissed off. But hey ho, this is really shaky.
I think I've done this walk like 100 times today, but hey ho. So I'm now going back to the field to hopefully get them both in, obviously one at a time, but hopefully get them in. And I'm not gonna fully bath Diddy, I'm just gonna give her a really good groom and then wash some of her stable stains. I just don't want to get her fully wet because it is not that warm. And then I will probably take her for a hack, and Blue will have to stay in the stable on his own because he is out of work. So yeah. Blue actually galloped all the way to the gate, so I've got him first. Diddy is still in the field. She's all right, she's not too happy, but I'll get her in like 5 seconds anyway. So
Diddy is galloping around the field again. Hello. She stood still, saw me, and started galloping. Diddy, I'm coming to get you. I was gone for about, let me think, Diddy, a minute. But hey ho, someone definitely wants to come in. Stopping for a snack in Diddy's books is very, very important. You coming in? She gon' go, I'm gon' just, she finesse, I fight books, she take.